In today's video, I'm going to test whether leaving CFexpress or SD cards inside the new Canon EOS R5 causes it to overheat while recording externally. And I'm going to test if leaving the camera screen on has an effect as well. So let's get started. Because other people reported getting over an hour plus with cards inside of the camera, and multiple hours without cards, I wanted to see if leaving each type of card inside of the camera made a difference. I also wanted to know if leaving the screen on causes overheating. Now, I'm not here today to bash the camera or anyone else's results. I just want to share with you my experience and my test results as another data point in the discussion. I've used Canon cameras for over 20 years, and I bought this camera with my own money, and I just want to test its capabilities so I know its limits when I use it in the field. Not based on someone else's assumptions or rumors, but with data from my own camera. I didn't even plan on conducting my own tests until I used my R5 for video for the first time on Friday. My C200, which I'm recording on right now, was my A camera, and I set up my R5 as my B camera on an interview. After about 40 minutes of recording in 24p 4K fine externally on my Atomos Shogun, with the cards inside of the camera, it overheated. I'm not sure how long I had the camera powered on before I hit record, but it was the first footage or stills that I shot that day. I also had my screen on the entire time so that I could monitor in real time the eye detection AF and just make sure that everything was okay. In retrospect, I wonder if I could have monitored the focus with the peaking on my Shogun with the screen on the camera turned off. Once I started grading the log footage, I was able to match it very closely to my C200's raw video, which is something I've never been able to do with my 5D Mark IV in 4K. So I'm really excited about using this camera in this way, and I just want to conduct these tests today to figure out what the right path forward will be. In the first test, I used the SD card only and was able to record for 28 minutes and 58 seconds. The second test, I used the CFexpress card only and recorded internally with the screen on the whole time, this time as well, for 27 minutes and 33 seconds. Then I switched over to external recording with my Atomos Shogun, again, capturing at 24p 422LT 4K. For the third test, I left the rear LCD on the entire time. The camera unfortunately overheated in only 15 minutes, which doesn't make a lot of sense given my experience Friday when I was doing basically the same thing and the camera ran for about 40 minutes. So I guess you'll just have to take those two results into consideration. Then I wanted to change the settings on the camera so that the screen would go off. So I changed screen viewfinder display to auto 2, and under power saving, I set the display off to 30 seconds and the viewfinder off to 1 minute. Now the in-body image stabilization and the autofocus were on the entire time. For the fourth test, I had no cards inside of the camera and I used two batteries inside of my grip. A new one at 60% charge and an old one with a 99% charge. Unfortunately, the batteries died at 2 hours and 49 minutes, so it is very possible that I could have kept recording even longer. For the fifth test, I left the SD card inside of the camera and recorded externally once again. And I started off with two older batteries, one at 36% and one at 90%. Now the batteries lasted the entire time, but unfortunately the camera overheated and stopped recording after 1 hour and 53 minutes. Now thanks to COVID-19, I actually have an infrared thermometer in my studio. And when I took the card out of the camera and took its temperature, it measured 103.5 degrees. I kept trying to use the thermometer at other times to get a reading off the top of the camera or the side of the camera or the cards, and this was the only time that I was able to measure any sort of result with the thermometer. It's not exactly scientific, but at least it's a little bit more info for you to have. For the sixth and final test, I had the CFexpress card inside and I was recording externally, once again, to the Atomos Shogun. Now, I expected this test to fail quicker than when I had the SD card inside, based on a video I saw on YouTube by No Life Digital, who theorized that the CFexpress card was the reason for the overheating. So I started anyway doing my test with low batteries in the camera, and unfortunately, they died 2 hours into the recording. Exactly 2 hours, which is a little bit suspicious, but it could just be a coincidence. Now, I didn't catch it right away, but I changed the batteries and had the camera feeding back to the screen within 7 minutes. And then it kept going until the card filled 45 minutes later. But the heat warning on the screen when the card filled up said 5 minutes. So maybe it would have been good for 3 hours if the batteries didn't die, and maybe a little less because of that gap that was there in the middle. So after I recorded and edited this entire video, I realized that I forgot something. So I set up my camera and did another test, this time with the screen on the entire time and no cards in the camera. And the camera overheated after 41 minutes and 46 seconds. I think you can conclude from all of these tests that leaving the screen on does seem to be a factor to overheating. But it doesn't appear that having a CFexpress card alone inside of the camera causes the problem, even though I was able to get about 90 more seconds of internal recording with an SD card over the CFexpress card. Now, I apologize if at any time today I said CFexpress. It's something I've been doing a lot lately. But remember that when I was recording externally with the SD card inside of the camera, I got a shorter record time than when I was recording externally with the CFexpress card inside of the camera. So I think the results about the cards are really inconclusive. But looking at what other people have found, I think the moral of the story is that you should keep the cards out of the camera as much as you can, and you should also do as much of the monitoring that you can on the recorder and keep the screen off. That way you'll run into fewer problems. I have total confidence now after doing these tests that this camera is going to work for me when I'm out there in the field working. I just have to do it with the constraints that, you know, the camera has and make it work for me. I also want to give a shout out today to my friend Gary Hughes, who is a fantastic headshot photographer, and he's also sharing his experiences with the R5 on his YouTube channel. So I'll leave a link to that below in the description. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for your time. If you have any questions or comments, please leave those below. And also give me a thumbs up. I really would appreciate it. Thanks again, stay safe, and have a great day.